Hi, greetings in the name of Jesus Christ. I am Majid Abel, ordained pastor from Pakistan. I am currently also moderator of the Presbyterian Church of Pakistan. In Pakistan, the history of the church goes back to more than 150 years when American Presbyterians and other denominations started sending missionaries there. And now we have an established church. Presbyterian Church is one of the largest denominations in the country. I personally knew Christ through my church and Sunday school, and through prayers of the elders of our church. I was 16 years old when I became more active in my faith, and I decided to become a pastor. Thankfully, in due time, I received my theological education from the Presbyterian Theological Seminary in Pakistan. And then I also had the opportunity to go to Louisville Seminary, Presbyterian Seminary, where I got my Master of Theology and my Doctor of Ministry. I am also proud of our partnership with the Presbyterian Outreach Foundation, Rob Weingartner, Han, and other friends. I'm so thankful to them for their leadership, their friendship, and the ministry that they have, and the support we receive from them for the building of Kingdom of Jesus Christ in the country of Pakistan. Pakistan is an Islamic state. Christians are a very small minority in this country. About 2.5 to 3% Christians live in Pakistan, and there are a lot of challenges socially, legally, economically. We face a lot of challenges. Thankfully, we have partners around the world who pray for us, and in times of struggle and challenges, they stand with us. We are so thankful to especially Outreach Foundation, who has very faithfully stood by us and are helping us in different projects and programs. I think one of the most important ministries in Pakistan is that being done at the Theological Seminary in Gujranwala, Pakistan. I am currently chairing the board, and also I'm their international liaison to build network for the seminary around the world. Seminary was going through very difficult time when outreach, Presbyterian outreach people, folks came and they helped us. And they are helping us to keep this institution surviving. And also we are able to share with them our future plans and working together to make it a stronger institution. In a country like Pakistan, where we live in a context which is Islamic, this seminary has a very significant role to play. And it's important for us that Gujranwala Seminary continues to do its ministry. We need stronger, able leadership, and this seminary is important, ultimate for that. Please continue to pray for the ministry of the Gujranwala Theological Seminary and our partnership with Outreach Foundation and Peace USA and believers around the world. One of the realities we live in is that Pakistan is an Islamic state. It was not Islamic to begin with. When Pakistan came into being, it was supposed to be a secular country, but gradually it moved toward radicalism, and eventually it was declared to be an Islamic state. Christians became second-rate citizens. And then subsequently, then blasphemy law was passed. According to blasphemy law, Muslims, if you offend a Muslim's faith, is punishable by death. And many big tragedies have taken place. People live in fear. This is a law that befall upon you anytime. It's like a sword dangling over your head 24 hours. So this is a huge challenge that Christians in Pakistan or minorities in Pakistan have. Many people are even today in jails. Accused under this law, and they are facing serious consequences. We think it's very important that we make efforts to do some bridge building among communities, Christians, Muslims, Hindus, so that the tension that exists between different communities can be minimized. Muslim people and Christian people come close, understand each other better, and they learn to live together. For this, we have in the past been working on organizing dialogues, forums, where we can provide opportunities to people of different communities to come together, to learn to be comfortable in each other's presence. 15 years ago, when I started inviting gatherings of people of different faith, there was a lot of reluctance from both sides. But I told my people especially that they may not need to know us, but we need them to know us. So that we build connections, and we, once we know each other, then there will be less fear of each other. So in the last 15 years, we have developed a very strong interfaith program. We have a local interfaith peace council. I'm the general secretary, and first I started with the developing relationship with five mosques that exist around my own church. Now the clerics and those mosques are just a phone call away. Then we spread that program, and now I know clerics and people from other faith, especially majority faith, all over the country. Every year we invite huge gatherings. The gatherings have started with 30, 35 people. Now we have 600 or more people who come to these programs. And during time of tragedies, when there are blasphemy cases or other issues that erupt among communities, this interfaith group that we have built, it comes out to help and work together. And I think for future peaceful living of minorities in Pakistan, it's important that we focus more on bridge building and interfaith peace building. Please continue to pray for this ministry also. It's very important ministry. This way, we don't wait for a tragedy to happen and then become active and resolve situations. We actually prepare ourselves, create forums and environment among ourselves that, God forbid, there is a tragedy. Then we will be working on it together to resolve the situation. So interfaith work in Pakistan is very important. It's need of the time. Thankfully, the church people are strong people. They do not give up, and they continue in their faith. We are thankful to once again Outreach Foundation for providing us funds to hire an accountant to keep the church's books right. They also provided us motorbikes for our pastors who are working in distant areas, rural areas, so that it can help their ministry in building the kingdom of God together. Presbyterian pastor's life in Pakistan is very challenging life. We, in the first place, we don't pay them any salaries. Our pastors are working as volunteers, and whatever in the field they get in offerings or just on faith they live, and somehow God provides them, but they continue working very, very faithfully. 80% of our pastors are working in rural areas. Rural areas in Pakistan are most backward and very poor areas. No public transport, no schools, no health institutions. Their children suffer, their children's careers suffer, but they are very faithful workers, and they continue hard work, and we give thanks to God for their dedication. So as a moderator, I am trying to find ways how I can make life easier for them. Thankful to Outreach Foundation, they provided us funds. We have provided motorbikes to 28 pastors already, and there are more in process. This way, our pastors will have easier access to the fields where area where they're working to reach to their congregations. Sometimes one pastor visits 10 or more villages on a Sunday, on an average Sunday. Because they do not have access to public transportation and they don't own transportation, that means that's why their life is even more difficult. But if we are able to provide them motorbikes, then it's easy for them to do their ministry better. Maybe their children who go to school to a distant village, maybe it's easier for the pastor to have their children in that way also. If someone in the family gets sick or in the congregation gets sick, they can have a quicker mean of travel, their motorbike. They can take that to maybe hospital. But motorbike in Pakistan is a very handy means to have for transportation. So these are some of the genuine needs our pastors have, and please remember them in your prayers. Unlike American setting, there is no minimum wage we give to. We rather don't give them anything. But they are dedicated workers. They feel called, and very faithfully they are working in urban and rural areas in Pakistan. Please remember them in your prayers. To all my Christian brothers and sisters around the country and at Outreach Foundation, I want to say thank you for all your prayers and your continued love and care that we receive from you. One thing that I want to add today is that when people want to contribute somewhere, they want to be part of some ministry, they set priorities. And then they communicate with the possible people that they can work with, the possible needs that they can work with. And I think that their priorities are also very meaningful and very important, because they mean a lot to them, and they expect that the beneficiaries also value that. But as a Pakistani church leader, I have also felt that sometimes it's important to see what the beneficiaries may seem more important need. Everybody wants to contribute for education. Everybody wants to contribute for health. Everybody wants to contribute for clean water. But sometimes communities, the challenges they are facing, there may be something that they think is more meaningful. And I think that this kind of message sharing and interpretation can help us both understand the need better and try to fulfill that need. I hope that in future this partnership will get stronger, and people who will listen to this message, they will pray for us and remember us in their prayer, and we will also pray for all of you, and hopefully we can continue our faithful work in the field that God has brought us in.